episode 1257, for the sake of your health.
It's time to train for life and love your journey. In this episode of Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, you'll learn new ways to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew your mind, body, and spirit. Please welcome your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy, happy day. How is your summer going? Well, hopefully it is going very, very well. It is Wellness Wednesday, and it's time for The Sake of Your Health. For those of you who are brand new to Create Your Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com, where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, for most of us, we know what our body needs, but it's easy to get distracted by what we see others doing. But for the sake of your health, listen to what your body is telling you. For many years, I found myself chasing everyone else's successes. If it worked for them, it's gotta work for me. I mean, seriously, right? That's what we think. But that's not what happened. I only spent more money. I only gained more frustration. I only hated my body more. And I only continued down a path of failure. It was called the roller coaster of life, the roller coaster of health and wellness. But it wasn't either of those. It wasn't health and it wasn't wellness. I was destroying my body little by little, and I didn't know I was doing it. And that only discredited my judgment even more. Big loser, but not the big loser I wanted to be. Plus, I did damage every single time I tried something new just because of what I saw. And it showed up, you know, on the TV, the advertisements, mailings, infomercials, and social channels now. All was so tempting. It was convincing. And I was a smart cookie. It wasn't like I didn't know. For the sake of your health, though, listen to what your body is telling you. When you're wanting something different for your body, whether it be weight-related or general health-related, you become desperate. You grasp at anything that offers a bit of hope. 5 pounds would be better than no pounds or gaining pounds. That's how we reason. And we're like, oh, I'll try that because if I can get 5 pounds off, maybe I'll go and be able to reach 10 pounds. And then you see those results and all that's like, oh, you're going to lose 20 pounds in 10 days. Really? Yeah, let's talk. But first, let's pause for a word from our sponsor, Health Open Inspiration with Reverend Percy McRae, a podcast created by Cancer Treatment Centers of America to provide cancer care information and resources to the faith-based community. A cancer diagnosis has historically been considered by many as life-threatening, but that is not always the case. If you or someone you love has cancer, there is hope. Every week on the Health, Hope, and Inspiration podcast, Reverend Percy McRae will inspire you with practical information for your real-life questions about cancer prevention, treatment, and overall healthy living. To be encouraged today, tune in and listen each week by subscribing to the podcast at healthhopeandinspiration.com. So if you were to quiet the distractions, turn off the tempting commercials, what would your body tell you? Sometimes our body talks in loud, loud shouts. My body does that. That's when I'm laying in bed. And before the children even enter the room, they're like, Mom, is your stomach going off? I mean, you could hear the coyotes. I've told and shared the story of my coyotes in the stomach. And it's horrible. If I eat the wrong thing, it's like, roar, roar, roar. It's just, it's not even, I mean, seriously, one of these days, okay, maybe not one of these days, because I don't like feeling that way. If your body is talking to you, making noises that you know it shouldn't be making, then you need to start listening to it. And sometimes our body talks in whispers. Maybe you just feel a little off and you don't know why. It's not the flu or the little cold or you didn't catch something from your little cute, adorable niece. It's just something your body's saying you're off. Something's not right. Think about how you feel when you eat certain foods. Think about how you feel when you sit too long, like at a movie. You know, you get up and you're like, oh my gosh, I sat into that hip. I do that now. Part of it's from my running for years upon years upon years. And I really, really wore down some areas that I shouldn't have been wearing down. But I get stuck in these positions. And sometimes if I sit in the hip the wrong way, I'm like, oh, and you just got to move and get up. You know, we sit too long. It's not good for us. Think about how you feel when you drink stuff in cans that sizzle when you open them, and later they what? Sizzle in your tummy. How do you feel when you stay up late and abandon a good night's sleep? Oh, I gave up good night's sleeps. I don't know. I can't count. I would need to have probably about 200 people in front of me to count as many fingers and toes that they have in order to really, you know, calculate what I did. That's not good for your body. But what do? We're like, oh, we either make up excuses or we settle in and saying, okay, it's acceptable. For me, I convinced myself that it was acceptable. But it wasn't. For the sake of your health, listen to what your body is telling you and do this, not that. That is your KISS, the Keep It Simple strategy. Do this, not that. The this is the THIS. We're all into the this and that's, right? We got to go do this before we can do that. Well, we're going to do this today, and it's about your health. So let's break it down. What does it look like? You need to incorporate, number one, the T for this, traditional real foods. I'm talking about going back to the good old days. Your fresh fruits and veggies. If you are one who eats protein, then eat real protein. Don't eat this processed stuff. Stop overeating the processed easy grab foods. Stay away from them. This is going to help you to reduce what? Unnecessary sugar and salt consumption. And this in general will work for not just you, but for your children, for your husband, for your mom and dad. You know, we're getting older too, but what does that mean for our parents? Our parents are also getting older. I know when my grandmother was getting older, you know, for me, it was just like she was always young. I always saw her as that. And then it came to a point where her health was failing her. And it was more of her age first in her mind, and then her health finally failed. She was never on medications until the very, very end of her life. She was an extraordinary, healthy woman. And one thing that I always can remember with her is she always would tell me, sweetheart, whatever you do, always eat a colorful plate. And I thought, well, I'll take yellow or purple or blue. She didn't mean the actual plate. Okay, I'm a little girl here thinking about all this. She meant what was on the plate. I've never forgotten that, ever, ever. And I know I've shared it many times with you. But sometimes we need to hear these things over and over and over again. As she was getting older, I would remind her, Grandma, you need to eat a colorful plate. Because as she got older, it was easier for her to what? Grab the processed food. Because she was getting older, she couldn't stand as long, or she would tire more quickly. And so then my mom and my sister who were taking care of her, they would go and they would cook meals and take it over to her. You got to eat traditional real foods, not just for your body, but make sure your children are doing it too. And if that means you've got a child that will only eat one type of real traditional food, then guess what? Feed them that one food that they love. At least they're getting something good from it. Then eventually, as they grow older, I promise you their taste buds will change. I know. I'm seeing it in one of my children. My little Einstein, Noah, he is beginning to experiment and he's trying new things. In fact, he came down yesterday for dinner and he said, Mom, I'll try some of that. And I'm like, really? You don't like this? He goes, I'll try it. And I didn't say you don't like this out loud. I said it in my head because I didn't want to remind him that he doesn't like this. I thought, okay, this is great. And he knew I would be shocked. And he says, well, I'm going to try it. And I said, okay, wait, but I'm going to put some seasoning on it. Do you want to taste it plain or with seasoning? He goes, how about both? And I said, you got it. There is hope, I'm telling you. But if you want to really have a healthy body, you've got to do this. And it starts with traditional, real foods. Get away from those over-processed foods. I know they're tempting. But if you were just to take that out of your diet, oh my goodness, it would totally change how your body reacts to things, okay? I mean, you're going to take out sugar and salt consumption, and those are two big whammies that you don't want when it comes to your diet. You want to support your nutrition for your body. Remember, nutrition, your diet is fuel for the body. So incorporate traditional real foods. The H, number two, H, heaven and heart connection. God's got you. Talk to him. You know, here at Create Your Now, it's about the mind, body, and spirit. It's the Trinity lifestyle. It takes all three. Heaven and heart connection is huge. Maybe you have wandered away from your devotionals. Time you come back. Get back in the Word. Maybe for you, your schedule and in your season of life that you're in, you know what? God says you don't have to be on your knees to pray. I'm praying when I'm cooking. I'm praying when I'm driving. My eyes are not closed, by the way, when I'm driving. I pray in the shower. I sometimes even pray on the toilet. I know, TMI. But I'm being real and honest with you. Heaven and heart connection. God doesn't stipulate where and when to pray. He wants you all the time. So do this. Traditional real foods. Heaven and heart connection. Number three is the I, right? We got the TH. Now I, intentional movement. Stop sitting so long and move more daily, not just one, two, or three times a week and you're resting everything else. No, daily. Go for a walk. Park your car further away when you're going to the box store. Those steps add up. Your hubby may want to be really sweet and wants to drop you off at the front saying, no, sweetheart, I want us to walk together, hand in hand. Take those extra steps. It doesn't mean that you have to go do some crazy exercise and fitness routine every single day, but you need to move intentionally. I know for me, summertime is really, really tough. The kids are home and I don't necessarily have to go anywhere all the time. I don't need to travel and go out and about. I do a lot of my stuff at home except for running the errands and maybe grocery shopping and a few things like that. We'll go to church, obviously. But the intentional movement, I have to make sure because with what I do, I can find myself sitting more than moving more. And so for me, when I'm reading a book, I'm not sitting down. I might be walking on the treadmill or walking the neighborhood. I might be riding my stationary bike. I may read for 20 minutes or so, sitting down, being still, and then I get up and I move for 15 minutes or so. You've got to incorporate intentional movement into your day. Not into your week, but into your day. Okay, if you're like, well, I intentionally move. I work out a couple times a week. Great. Make it every day of the week. And the workout doesn't mean that it's aerobic. It doesn't mean that it has to be all cardio. It doesn't mean that it's strength training all the time. Movement, walking, whether it's a nice casual walk or a brisk walk. If you are in an area that it's not real nice weather right now, then get out and go to a mall or an indoor area. Find an indoor track, okay, near your area. If you have a beautiful day outside, then go to the park. There's no better way to feel good than getting connected in nature with intentional movement. It's incredible. It truly is. And if you haven't gone for a walk in a really long time, I would encourage you. I would truly, honestly encourage you. I know for me, when I went through my tornado in life, intentional movement was key for me. I thought I was moving a lot. And I was getting less than 4,000 steps a day. And I was a busy, crazy mom. I was going all over the place. My day started early at around 5 o'clock and didn't end till close to 9:30 or 10. That's with the children. And it continued until almost midnight. That was my full day. So I was getting about average on a good night, 5 hours of sleep. On my best night, I might get 6. And on my okay night, I would get like 4 hours of sleep. It was very important for me to have that intentional movement. So get up and get moving. And finally, do this, not that. Number 4, the S is sleep. Stop staying up late and not prioritizing your sleep. Sleep is important. Now, I'm not going to get all scientific on you here, but you need sleep to, number 1, repair your body. So if you're working out, if you're doing strength training, your muscles repair when you are sleeping. So if you're killing yourself with a great workout and you're still kind of feeling sluggish a day or two later when you should be doing another workout, you're probably needing to look at your sleep. And number 2, you want to have the human growth hormone, right? You want that to be on your side. You need to sleep more because that's when it ramps up. You want that because that helps with what? Weight loss. It helps with your overall health and healing of the body. So do this, not that. Traditional real foods, heaven and heart connection, intentional movement, and sleep. And a word to the wise, do what works for you for the sake of your health. My body is very complicated, but through extensive research and past failures and successes, I have found that intermittent fasting works extremely well for me. Now, some of you may have heard of intermittent fasting and some may have not. Most people have heard of the term fasting. Well, intermittent fasting is something that is somewhat controversial, okay? It's one that's like, either some people really love it or they have this relationship of like, it's just a question mark. But I chose to listen to my body. When I do intermittent fasting, it works for me. I'm at my prime when I'm doing it. Now, one of these episodes, we will go into detail about intermittent fasting because you may be interested in that. And if you are, I would love to hear from you. Okay. My link is in the show notes and you can just click on Take Aim. All right. That, even if you just want to ask me a question, maybe you don't want that free gift of a coaching call. Go ahead, fill it out and say, I just have a question for you. I'll respond to you, okay? But what is important here to understand for the sake of your health is we've got to start listening to our bodies more. Right now, we've got so much noise happening. And I hope here over these next few weeks, we're going to be able to kind of dive even deeper when it comes to your health. What diet and nutrition really looks like. What is fitness and exercise? How does it blend? How do you create harmony between the two of them and then bringing in the mind? Okay. It's not easy creating harmony, but that's ultimately what you're doing within your body. Because again, when you look at food, you see something, but your body says it's chemical. So when you chew it up and swallow it, it's a chemical reaction. But you're like, oh, but it's wonderful. It's this scrumptious blueberry and apple cobbler. There's real blueberries and apples in it. It can't be all that bad for me. But your body may decide differently. Or it may be okay and may say, oh, yeah, it's fine. Every person is different. And I cannot stress enough, one size does not fit all. So don't get, you know, caught up in the craziness, the noise out there. The intermittent fasting for me works. And if I would have listened to people, even within my own, you know, people that I trust, They would have been like, you're crazy to do that. And I'm like, but okay, I'm going to try it. And I just need you to support me while I do it. And if you don't like it, then don't talk to me about it. But I need to listen to my body. I need to see if this works for me. Taking care of your body is a lot of work. It can be a full-time job. And if you're in a position of needing to get healthier, meaning that you need to lose weight, maybe you're trying to reduce your amount of fat within your body, you're trying to strengthen your muscles because maybe over the last few years you've noticed that, you know, you're losing muscle and you're trying to build that back up and you want to create lean muscle, it's all work. But I promise you that if you are willing to believe that you are worthy, did you hear that? If you are willing to believe that you are worthy, then nothing is impossible and nothing's going to stop you getting to where you want to be when it comes to your health and wellness. Nothing will stop you. But when you begin to put that question mark as to, gosh, I don't know. I just don't know if I have time for this, or I'll just hit the snooze button because I really don't want to get up for, you know, 15 minutes early to do the workout. You are worth it. For the sake of your health, do this, not that. Think about what you're doing. It's time to train for life and love your journey. I love you so much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.